Okay, so the radio station we're talking about is LBC, which stands for Leading Britain's Conversation, and it's a national talk radio station. It's just strictly just talking and discussing, and it's owned by Global. And what makes this a little bit different is that you can phone in to the presenter and also you have your say on the debate. Now, usually they mostly cover more news that's like political, but also they cover other bits of news as well. And they don't have to just phone in, they can also tweet at the presenters as well, or send a text message. And in terms of the genre of music, they don't really play any music, it's just strictly just talking. And you can tune into it online or on 97.3 FM.
Yeah, this is it's purely like a talk radio show, no music at all. Each broadcaster does like a different type of show. There's 20 broadcasters. This is the schedule for Monday. So they all have different like genres in the show.
Now they also got some special shows as well. Like you can also ask a question to good old Boris Johnson or to Duke Khan if you wish. And also they also hold like special quizzes as well to like fill in the gaps when the main presenters are not on.
They've got 20 presenters and they've all got certain slots that during the day. Some of them will have like the breakfast slot, some of them have like the night slot. Obviously the night slot won't be as watched as much. Like I've said it before, but they've all got different like genres. Like for example, one might be about random stuff like war heroes, one might be about current events, world events. It's won quite a few awards.
It's basically whatever happens in the news.
Yeah.
But gets covered.
And they've got some award winning presenters, but they haven't really got that many famous ones. They have some political figures like Nigel Farage has a show on there.
So the conventions, as we said, it's about 99% speech, and obviously the presenters are very open with their audience, they're quite relaxed. And they also play some jingles at the start to sort of introduce the show, and obviously there's a bit of silence at the end. And another thing that makes it a bit different is that you can also watch like a video online, like either on the website or on YouTube, of the presenters speaking in the studio while the radio is shows being broadcast.
Statistics here shows that went down a lot because during this time there was a rise in other talk shows, so they lost quite a lot of their
market shares.
And as well, that's the same with this is their listeners and that's the market shares. It also went down, but it's like slowly on the rise again.
It's roughly about just over 2% market share. They also got 2.1 million listeners a week. And in terms of the target audience, it's mostly aims at people over the age of 20 and above, more middle class. 58% of listeners are male, 41% are female. Yes, it's company growing. That's it.
Thank you. Any questions? Any gaps in your grids? Can I then ask you, whilst everybody's still making notes, can I ask you who your major competition is with the talk show kind of?
I don't. It's just like there is a bit of competition, but it's not like anything that poses a threat to LBC.
It's
I think the only one I can think of
because it dropped a bit when other talk shows.
For example, which ones?
I couldn't tell you, but I could find
it's
out.
It's more like local talk shows, I think.
And what do you think of the kind of innovation in terms of social media usage? You go first.
They've got Instagram, Facebook, but it's more to do with the presenters. Like they have their specific social media accounts and stuff, and they've got that many followers. The actual no, they haven't. the average, well, obviously they've got more than the average person, but in terms of like an organisation, they haven't got that many.
Any questions from that? Sorry, Joe, were you...
Sorry, I was just going to say, most people just phone in, they have like tweet or text.
Do you think that's anything to do with your audience? You've got, I noticed on your slide you had an audience profile of ABCs mainly, C1s and above. Yeah,
so that's like obviously higher up in the social.
Kind of what type of?
It's like doctors and stuff like that, and obviously the majority of them will be older, and older people don't really use the old social media.
What do you mean by old people don't use social media?
Well, I'm sure like a doctor, 60, you'd rather ring in than, they don't know, he probably doesn't know.
Okay, you just had to go by gendered language. Why did you refer to a doctor as a he? Come on, ladies and gents, ask some questions. No? Do you think is the lack of questioning the fact that they covered such a lot of information in the presentation?
Yeah.
Go on then, sit down. Thank you. Well done.